Once you stop learning, you start dying. Hi Chantri Views, welcome to you all for the online class. Class 4, Subject Social, Lesson 1. Our topic of our Lesson 1, The Zones of the Earth. Before we move into the class, let's see the introduction of the Zones of the Earth. The Earth is divided into 5 distinct zones based on their climate conditions, known as geographical zones. So these zones are the North Vigrid Zone, the North Temperature Zone, the Tropics, the South Vigrid Zone, the South Temperature Zone. So from in upcoming class, we're going to learn each zones in briefly. Let's start our class. Hi children, how are you? Hope you are fine with your good health. Do you know my name? You would have studied about me in 3rd standard. Do you remember? Yes, you are correct. My name is Earth. Do you know why did I came here today? Let me tell you why. Today, we are going to learn about the zones of the earth. No one can explain better than me. Do you know why? Because I enjoy these zones in me. I have different type of zones. Let me explain you briefly in this class. Are you ready to hear, children? Let's go to the class now. Listen carefully. Introduction. The world is sometimes divided into 5 zones according to the latitude. The tropical or torrid zone. Tropical or torrid zone is the same meaning, lies near the equator and extends to the Tropic of Cancer in the north. So you can able to see north side, the Tropic of Cancer will be present and the Tropic of Capricorn will be in the south, downside. The north and the south Vigrid zones, also known as the Arctic and the Antarctic, lie near the poles. So what is meant by the Vigrid zones? I have explained you the north and the south Vigrid zones, right? So what is meaning of the Vigrid zone is each of the 2 area of the earth respectively, the north of the Arctic Ocean and the south of the Antarctic Ocean, that have given in the bracket. So kindly note it, my dear children. So that is a meaning for Vigrid. So lies near the poles. This is the introduction. Let's be more for our earth. The earth is the planet on which we live. The people usually say earth when they are referring to the planet as a part of the universe. The earth is a land surface on which we live and move about. So we all know that our earth is a very beautiful planet, right? And the distance between the sun and the earth made the life possible on the earth. So it is protected from the ultraviolet rays of the sun by the upper layer of the atmosphere. For example, we can say ozone layer, right? So we can see the shape of the earth. What is the shape of earth? It is a spherical in shape, right? So we know that the shape of the earth is spherical, like a ball. So Aryabhatta, a Eminist, Aristotelist and greatest mathematician of India was the first person in the world to state about the shape of the earth, eclipse and distance between the sun and the earth and the moon. Later, Aristotle and Copernicus also proved the same. And Columbus, discoverer of America. We all know that, right? So next, our Mahalian traveled around the world and Gagarini traveled into the space and Neil Armstrong traveled to the moon. The photographs of the earth taken by the spacecrafts also reveal that the earth is spherical in shape. So this is all about our space Next, we are going to study about the layers of the earth. Right. So the earth is the terrestrial or the inner planet consisting of this outer crust, the intermediate mantle and the dense inner core. So what is meant by terrestrial? Is increase the ultraviolet radiation may disturb terrestrial ecosystem. That is a meaning for terrestrial, right? So in the slide you can able to see the solid earth. The inner core 1300 km radius, in outer core 1300 to 3500 km, in mantle 3500 to 6400 km, is crust, is top mantle and 5 to 50 km. Here we can see the earth layers, right? The internal structure of the earth. So the crust is a silicate solid. The mantle is a viscous mantle rock. The outer core is a viscous liquid and the inner core is a dense solid. Clear? So let's see the crust. Crust is the outer layer of the earth. Next, when coming to the mantle, it is an orange color they have described. In outer core, it is an yellow color. In its inner core is in the red color. Clear? So, crust. The crust is the earth crust is what we walk on every day, right? So mantle is just below to the crust lies the mantle. Next, coming to outer core. So coming to outer core, the outer core lies beneath the mantle. Inner core, the inner core is the deepest layer on the earth. So that's all about the earth's layer we have seen now. Next, we shall move for it as an atmosphere composed primarily of the nitrogen and the oxygen, and this is only a planet on which water is in a liquid form, which covers more than 70% of its surface. So we all know that Earth is the third planet, right, from the Sun. So about 29.2% of Earth's surface is land, consisting of continents and icelands. So the remaining of 70.8% is covered with the water, mostly by oceans, seas, gulfs and other salt water bodies. So the Earth atmosphere consists mostly of nitrogen and oxygen. The Earth's orbits around the Sun is about 365.25 days, right? So Earth is the distanced planet in the solar system and largest and most massive of the four rocky planets. Almost 8 billion humans live on the Earth and depend on its biosphere and natural resource for their survival. So these all about the one of the part of the Earth. Next, the Earth is the thirdest planet from the Sun and it is the largest of the terrestrial planet in the solar system. It has both diameter and its masses. Before that, we all want to know. So many millions of years ago, people thought that the Earth was the center of the universe and that Earth is the flat. Then it was a flat. So there are many theories which describe how the earth came, and none of them came to know the correct that solution. So later, Copernicus, a great astronomer, proved that the sun is in the center and 8 planets revolve around it, just like the earth. There are the 8 planets go around the sun. So some of these planets might either bigger or smaller. The family of the planets is called solar system. Okay, so our earth is one of the planets of our solar system. So there are 8 planets in our solar system. They are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. So these planets revolve around the sun in their particular orbits. So the solar system formed 4.6 billion years ago, right, from the gravitational collapse of the giant interstellar molecular cloud. The vast majority of the system mass is in the sun, with a majority of the remaining mass contained in the Jupiter. So the 4 smaller inner system planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, or the terrestrial planets. You know what is my terrestrial planets, right? Earth-like glands made up of rocks or metals with a hard surface. That is mean by terrestrial planets. So these are the terrestrial planets. What are that? Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars. So being a primary compound of the rock and matter. The four outer system planets or giant planets being a substantially more massive than terrestrials. The two largest planets are Jupiter and Saturn or the gas giants being composed mainly of hydrogen and helium. Then last, the two outermost planets is Uranus and Neptune or the ice giants being composed mostly of the substance with relatively high melting points compared with the hydrogen and helium called the volatiles such as water, amino and methane. All eight planets have almost circular orbits that lie with nearly flat disk called the eclipse, right? So this is about our solar system. I hope you all understood, right? Yes. Next we shall move for the depth of the earth. Now we shall see the depth. The depth is a form the surface to the center. The depth of the earth measures 3963 miles. The elements of the earth is made up of iron, oxygen, silicon, magnesium, sulfur, calcium, aluminium and other terrestrial elements. Yes, now we are seeing about the depth of the earth, right? So depth of the earth is measured of 3963 miles. We all know that. So what are the elements is made up of by our earth? Iron, oxygen. Iron you can able to see in the slide clearly the center in black color. Yes, in black color that is iron. Next is coming a silicon. It's in white color. Oxygen is in a light green color. Neon is in a violet color. And carbon it is in a blue. And last it's coming a helium, and entirely it is a hydrogen, covered by the hydrogen. They have described it clearly in this picture, right? I hope you all understood, right? So what are the elements? That the earth is made up of iron, oxygen, silicon, magnesium, sulfur, calcium, aluminium and other trace elements also present in this part, right? Yes. Next we shall move for formation of the earth. The solar system settled into its current layout for about 4.5 billion years ago. Earth is formed when the gravity pull swirling gases and the dust into become the third planet from the sun, right? So how its formation, how the Earth is formed? We are going to learn that. So our planet began as a part of a cloud of dust and gases. It has evolved into our home, which has an abundance of rocky landscapes and an atmosphere that supports a life and oceans filled with the mysterious. Clear? Then we live on the Earth's hard, rocky surface and breathe the air that surrounds the planet. Drink the water that falls from the sky and eat the food that grown in the soil. But Earth did not always exist within this expansive universe, and it was not always a hospitable heaven for life. This is all about the formation of the Earth. So under the gravity, this core collapsed and is thought to have formed the solar system. They have described it clearly in this slide, right? Right. Next, the earth as a central core and the rocky mantle and the solid crust. We have seen in the before itself, earth as a central core, rocky mantle and solid crust. The inner core is a solid sphere and made up of iron and nickel metals about 759 miles, that is 1221 kilometers is radius. They have clearly shown in the slide. See clearly, the inner core of the solid sphere is made up of iron and nickel. You can able to see this picture, right? Is that is made up of iron and nickel metal. Next, Earth's formation of the earth started since 6600 million years ago. The stage or involve the formation of the earth first, the second is the formation of mantle and formation of the Asian platform. So my dear children, a billions of years ago, Earth along with the rest of our solar system was initially unrecognizable, existing only as an enormous cloud of dust and gas. Eventually, a mysterious occurrence, once one that even the world's foremost scientists have yet been unable to determine and create the disturbance in the dust coal, setting forth a string of events that would lead to the formation of life as we know it. Right, so one common belief among the scientists is that a distant star collapsed, creating a supernova explosion, which is distribute this dust coal and cast it to pull together. This formed a spinning disk of gas and dust known as a solar nebula. That is known as a solar nebula. The faster the coal spin, the more the dust and gases become the concentrated at the center, further the fooling speed of the nebula. Over the time, the gravity at the center of the coal becomes so intense that hydrogen atom become to move more rapidly and violently. Clear? So the hydrogen protons begin fusion and forming the helium and releasing the massive amount of energy. That is releasing the massive amount of energy. This led to the formation of the star that is the central point of our solar system. So that the sun, roughly 4.6 billion years ago, it was formed. Like this only our Earth formation is present. Clear? So these are the stages is followed: the formation of the Earth, formation of the mantle, and formation of the Asian platforms. The Earth's surface began to cool, which allowed a crust to form. The gases also started to accumulate, and atmosphere began to develop 3.8 billion years ago. The oceans of water were present with the volcano islands and scattered across them. So, how our Earth formation is there? So the formation of the sun is consumed more than 99% of the matter in the nebula. The remaining particle begin to collapse into various masses. The cloud was still spinning of a matter, continued to collide with others. Eventually, some of those clusters of matter grew large enough to maintain their own gravitational pull, which shaped them into the planets and dwarf planets that make up our solar system today. So the Earth is one of the four inner terrestrial planets in our solar system. Just I have explained you what are the Mercury, Venus and Mars. It is relatively small and rocky, right? So early in the history of the solar system, rocky material was the only substance that could exist so close to the sun and withstand its heat. So this was about our Earth, and also the oceans of water were also present in our Earth in the volcano islands and scattered across them. Here we have learned about the formation of the Earth. Next, it would be another 2 billion years before large land masses and breathable air appeared and complex organisms were living in the oceans. The first humans did not arrive for another 1.9 million years after. Clear? So, the first humans did not arrive for another 1.6 billion years so after that. So, first, we all know, I have not known about the Earth. There was no humans is present. After the scientists giving the information only, we found the Earth and we are living in that Earth surface. Clear? Yes. Next, we shall move for the composition of the Earth. The outer layer of the Earth is made up of the solid rock, mostly basalt and the granite. So there are two types of crust: the ocean crust and continental crust. So we're going to see briefly about this crust and the lithosphere, right? So in our Earth's outer surface is its crust, a cold and thin and brittle outer shell made up of rock. So crust is very thin and related to the radius of the planet. So there are two very different types of crust, each with its own distinctive physical and chemical properties, like ocean crust. First, we will see what is about the ocean crust. Ocean crust. So, ocean crust is composed of the magma that erupts on the sea floor to create the basalt lava folds. Basalt lava folds or cools deeper down to create the intrusive and igneous rock gabbro. Sediments and primarily muds and shells of the tiny sea creatures that coat the sea floor. The sediment is thick thickest near the shore, where it's come off the continents in rivers and on wind currents. So this is all about the ocean crust. Next we shall move for continental crust. So what is meant by ocean crust? Is composed of magma and that erupts on the sea floor to create the basalt lava floats, or cooler deeper down to create the intrusive igneous rock cabro, right? So this is all about the ocean crust. Next we shall move for continental crust. So continental crust is made up of many different types of the igneous and metamoric and sedimentary rocks. So average composition is a granite, which is much less dense than the igneous rocks of the ocean crust, because it is thick and has relatively low density, and continental crust is rise higher on the mantle than ocean crust, which sinks the mantle, the ocean crust, which sinks into the mantle to form the basins, right? So when filled with the water, these basins from the planet oceans, the lithosphere is the outermost mechanical layer. Clear? So lithosphere is the outermost mechanical layer, which behaves as a brittle and rigid solid. So the lithosphere is about 100 kilometers thick, and definition of the lithosphere is based on the how the earth materials behave. So it includes the crust and the upper premost mantle, which are both brittle. Since it is a rigid and brittle, when stresses act on the lithosphere, it breaks. So this is what we experience as an earthquake, whether you have got it right. Next, the ocean crust is a denser and thinner and mainly composed of the basalt. I have explained to you about the ocean crust before itself, right? The ocean crust is composed of the magma that erupts on the seafloor to create the basalt lava and flows, or we can see the cool deeper down to create the intrusive igneous rock grabber. And sediments and primarily muds and shells of the tiny sea creatures coat the seafloor, and sediment is thickest near the shore where it's come off the continent in river and on wind currents. So these all about the oceanic crust. I have explained you clearly about the basalt, right? Yes. Next, the continental crust and ocean crust, they have described it in this slide briefly. Now we are going to see continental crust as the outermost layer of the earth's lithosphere that makes up the planet continents and continental shelves, and is formed near the substitution zones at the plate boundaries between the continental and ocean tectonic plates and continental crust from the nearly all the earth's land surface. It's all about the continental crust and the ocean crust, my dear children. After when the composition of the earth is in the first slide itself, I have explained you about the continental crust and the ocean crust, right? So continental crust, again I will remind you that the continental crust is made up of many different types of, okay? So what are that? Igneous, metamoric and sedimentary rocks, these are that. So next we shall move for earth. The earth has an outer core and a highly various mantle and liquid outer core and solid inner core. The shape of the earth is a plate spheroid, and because it is slightly flattened at the poles and the bulging at the equator. So already we have know that in the earth, the layers, it is a crust and a mantle and the core is present. So in the crust, there will be the core, the outer core. The earth has outer core and the highly various mantle, and there are liquid outer core and solid inner core. So we have seen that, right? So the shape of the earth is oblate spheroid because it's slightly flattened at the force. Yes, because the force, it will be slightly flattered, and the bulging at the equator. What is meaning of the bulging? The gradual increase of the radius of the planet or star from the poles to equator, that is resulting in the diversion from the perfect spherical shape caused by the object rotation. That is the meaning for bulging. Okay, so at the equator, this is all about the composition of the earth. Next we shall move for structure of the earth. structure of the earth. The earth is made up of three different layers. They are the crust, mantle and the core. So we are going to see in the structure of the earth the brief explanation of the crust, the mantle, the outer core and inner core. First is a crust. So this is the outside layer of the earth. We all know that, right? What is the outside layer of the earth? The crust. And it's made up of solid rock, mostly basalt and granite. So there are two types of crust, oceanic and continental. And the oceanic crust is denser and thinner and mainly composed of the basalt. And continental crust is less dense and thicker and mainly composed of the granite. Okay, so what is meaning of the crust? What does they have described is the crust is the outermost layer of the earth, making up 0.5 to 1.0% of the earth volume and less than 1% of the earth mass. Clear? So earth is the outermost layer of the earth, making up 0.5 to 1.0% of the earth volume, less than 1% of earth mass. So density increases with depth, and the average density is about 2.5 gram by centimeter per power 3. So average density of the earth is 5.51 gram by centimeter power by 3. So thickness of the crust varies in the range of 5 to 30 kilometers in the case of the ocean crust and as 50 to 70 kilometers in the case of the continental crust. We all know that crust, we have in the two types, ocean crust and the continental crust, right? So they have seen explaining that. And in the continental crust can be thicker than 70 kilometers in the area, so the major mountain system, and it as much as 70 to 100 kilometers thick in the Himalayan range. The temperature of the crust increases with the depth, reaching values typically in the range from about 200 degrees Celsius to 400 degrees Celsius at the bottom with the underlying of the mantle, right? Next, temperature increases by as much as 30 degrees Celsius for every kilometers in the upper part of the crust. So the outer covering of the crust is the sedimentary material, and below that lies crystalline, igneous and metamoric rocks, which are the acidic in nature. So lower layer of the crust consists of the basaltic and ultra basic rocks. So this is all about the crust. And last, the ocean crust is composed of lighter sodium, potassium, and aluminium silicate rocks like granite. And the ocean crust, on the other hand, is composed of dense of iron, magnesium, silicate, igneous rocks like basalt, right? So this is all about the crust they have explained in this here. In the picture itself, you can able to identify in the crust the two types and the two sphere I have already explained you, right? Next, we shall move for mantle. Now, mantle lies below the crust and is up to 2,900 kilometers thick. It consists of hot, dense ions and magnesium and rich solid rock. The crust and the upper part of the mantle make up the lithosphere, which is broken into the plates, both large and small. To learn more about these plates, see in the plate tectonics page. Okay, so what is about the mantle is it forms about the 83% of the earth volume and holds 67% of the earth mass. Okay, so it extends from the Mohos discontinued to a depth of 2900 kilometers. Now what we have learned now, okay, so density of the upper mantle varies between the 2.9 gram by centimeter power 3 and 3.3 gram by centimeter power 3. So lower mantle extends beyond to the asthenosphere. It is in a solid state. The mantle is composed of silicate rocks that are rich in iron and magnesium relative to the overlying crust, right? So regarding its consist elements, the mantle is made up of 45% of oxygen and 21% of silicon and 23% of the magnesium, that is OSM. Like this you can able to remember OSM, oxygen, silicon and magnesium. So this mantle temperatures ranges from the approximately 200 degrees Celsius at the upper boundary, and the crust is approximately 4000 degrees Celsius at the core mantle boundary. So that's all about the mantle. Thus, when we coming to the core, we having the two types of core, right? Outer core and the inner core. So the core is the center of the earth. It's made up of the two types, liquid outer core and solid inner core. The outer core is made up of nickel, iron and the molten rocks. Temperature here can reach up to 50,000 Celsius, right? So nothing but outer core is surrounding the inner core, lies between the 2900 kilometers to 5100 kilometers below the earth's surface. Then in inner core extends from the center of the earth to 5100 kilometers below the earth's surface. So the inner core is generally believed to be composed primarily of iron 80% and some of the nickel is NEF. Clear? So and that like also the outer core is composed of the iron mixed with the nickel. The trace amount of lighter elements. This is the difference of the outer core and inner core. Next, we shall see the features of the earth. The earth consists of the land, air and the water and the love. The land consists of the mountain, valleys and flat areas. Yes, right. It consists of the air, land, water. Yes, some valleys, mountain, hills, plains or consists of our in our earth. Next. The earth is made up of different gases, mainly the nitrogen, oxygen. The water includes the oceans and lakes and rivers, streams, rain, snow and air and ice. That's all present in our earth. Next, earth is a rocky terrestrial planet. The earth is a special planet because it has an ocean around it and water is also covered above the 70% of earth's surface. We all know 70% of the earth's surface is covering, and in Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars, these are the terrestrial planets. We have seen it earlier, right? Yes. So earth is located at the optimum distance from the sun. It is neither too cold or too hot. Earth is a watery planet with 70% of earth's surface covered by the water. So already I have explained to you the earth is covered with 70% of water, right? Yes, I hope you all remember. The earth is a third planet and is about 29.2 of earth's surface is land consisting of the continents and islands. Remaining of 70.8 is covered with the water, mostly by oceans, seas, gulfs and other salt water bodies. We already learned that, right? And also earth atmosphere consists mostly of nitrogen and oxygen. That as they have given here. Next. The earth has an atmosphere which receives the heat from the sun by the solar rotation and loses the heat by the earth rotation. Clear? By the heat, it receives the heat from the sun. It receives the heat from the sun by the solar rotation and loses the heat by earth rotation. That's all. This is all about the features of the earth. Next, we are entering into the poles. So geographical pole or the geographic pole is either of the two points on the earth where the axis of the earth rotation interests it in surface. The north pole lies in the Arctic Ocean while the south pole is under the Antarctica. So in this picture you can able to see the magnet field lines in the center and the north pole, and you can able to see the south pole, right? Yes. The north and south poles are the two imaginary points where the axis would enter and exit from the earth. If the axis were a pole or a line, the equator is the imaginary primary reference line drawn around the earth off way between the north and south poles. Here it is the earth magnet field is kept in the center. So it's the two imaginary points where the axis would enter and exit from the earth if the axis were a pole or a line. So the equator, imaginary primary or reference line drawn around the earth. You can able to see a line around the earth, right? The drawn around the earth off way between the north to and south poles. Right, so what is all about the pole is a geographical pole is either of two points of earth where it is axis of rotation interests its surface. That is the, what are the two is north pole lies in the Arctic Ocean while the south pole is Antarctic. Now we are going to see about the north pole. So north pole is the northernmost point of the earth. It is a precise the point of the intersection of the earth axis and the earth surface. Its latitude is 90 degree of north and all lines of the latitude meet there. The North Pole, also known as the geographical North Pole and terrestrial North Pole, it is a point in the northern hemisphere where the earth axis of the rotation meets its surface. So overall, what is the concept of the North Pole is, a North Pole, also known as a geographical North Pole or terrestrial North Pole, is a point in the northern hemisphere where the earth axis of the rotation meets surface. Yeah. So it is called the true North Pole to distinguish from the magnetic North Pole. Then the North Pole is by definition the northern point on the earth lying diametrically opposite to the South Pole. It defines the latitude 90 degree north as well as the direction of the true north. At the North Pole, all the direction point the south, all lines of the longitude converge there. So its longitude can be defined as any degree value. Along the tight latitude circles, the counterclockwise is east and clockwise is west. The North Pole is at the center of the northern hemisphere. The nearest land is usually said to be some Iceland, that is a Kafikulben Iceland of the northern coast of the Greenland, about 700 km away. So though some perhaps semi-permanent gravel blanks like slightly closer, the nearest permanently is that, right? So while the South Pole lies in the continental land in the moss, the North Pole is located in the middle of the Arctic Ocean amid the waters that are almost permanently covered with the constantly shifting the ice sea. That's all about the North Pole. Clear? I hope you all understood what is the concept of the North Pole. Next, we shall move for the South Pole. The southernmost point on the surface of the earth and lies on the opposite side of the earth from the North Pole. So it is situated on the continent of Antarctica. Next, the southern end of the earth axis of rotation, located at 90 degrees south latitude at a point in Antarctica. The southernmost point on the earth, that point in Antarctica where the earth's axis of rotation passes through the earth's surface. Clear? So what is the concept of South Pole is, the South Pole is the southernmost point on the earth. So from the South Pole, all direction on the north, its latitude is 90 degrees south and all lines of the longitude meet there as well as at the North Pole on the opposite end of the earth. Clear? So the South Pole is located on the Antarctica, one of the earth's seven continents. Are you all clear about the South Pole? Yes. South Pole is southern end of the earth axis lying in the Antarctica about 300 miles south of the Ross of ice shelf. Near to that. Clear? Yes. Here we are going to see the difference between the North Pole and South Pole. So in the North Pole, it is a northern point of the earth axis. In South Pole, it is a southern point of the earth axis. Clear? So in North Pole, it is known as the Arctic region. We all know North Pole is placed in the Arctic region, South Pole is placed in the Antarctica, right? So it is known as the Arctic region that has a floating ice sheet with no landform. But in coming to the South Pole, a fused continent known as the Antarctica. The North Pole of the Arctic region located at the center of the Arctic Ocean. And coming to the South Pole, it's compressed Antarctica continent surrounded by the ozone. So the South Pole is compressed in the Antarctica continent and is surrounded by the ozone. At last, it is not as cold as the South Pole. But in the South Pole, it is colder than the North Pole. Clear? So you are clear with the difference between the North Pole and South Pole? Yes, I hope so. Next, again, North Pole to South Pole. The average winter temperature is 34 degrees Celsius. When coming to the South Pole, it is 49 degrees Celsius, right? So in the polar bears we can able to see in the North Pole, penguins we can able to see in the South Pole. So it has a less ice that the South Pole is actually as a frozen ocean. 90% of the ice masses on the earth, it is actually ozone ocean. It is a continent with the mountains, village and the lakes. Frozen ocean this side, and in this side, a continent of the mountain, village and the lakes. So these are between the North Pole and the South Pole. Again, the terrestrial mammals are found like fox, wolf, musk, ox, etc. These are the terrestrial mammals we can able to found in the North Pole. And terrestrial mammals are not found in the South Pole. We can't able to see in the South Pole side. The native people and ethnic groups live in the region. There is no human activity in that region. So this area of the North Pole is divided between the many countries. It is only area on the earth that does not belong to the any country. Simply we can able to identify clearly, there is giving a clear expression, my dear children. In that area there is no human being also is present in our native people or ethnic groups live in that region. No, North Pole, but there is a new human activity in which place? In the which pole? That is in the South Pole. Clear? And the area in the Southern Pole is divided between the many countries we can able to divide. Okay, but in coming to the North Pole, the area of the Earth that does not belong to any countries. So that's all about the North Pole and South Pole. Then now we are coming to the latitude. So latitude is a measurement of the distance from the north or the south of the equator. It is measured with 180 imaginary lines that form circles around the earth east-west parallel to the equator. A circle of the latitude is an imaginary ring linking all points sharing a parallel. The equator is a line of the 0° latitude. Next. The latitude or imaginary lines that have been drawn on the globe, one set running from the east to west and parallel to the equator are called lines of latitude. So the horizontal lines, the horizontal lines is all latitude. So there are some imaginary lines running parallel to the equator. As they do not meet at any point, so they are called the parallel lines. Clear? So they are otherwise called as a parallel or latitude. So we can say that parallel or the parallel lines drawn from the equator to the north to south. You can able to see in the picture, right? So their size get decreased from the equator to the poles. These lines are measured in degrees. So latitude which runs towards the North Pole are marked as N. It's marked as N that are called North Latitude. They are 90 in number. The latitude which runs towards the south, that is marked as a S, are called South Latitude. They are also marked as a 90 in number. So the total number of the latitude is 180. So latitude on the north is North Pole, that marked as 90° north and 90° latitude. On the south, it is the South Pole and is marked as the 90° south. The 0° is the equator. Now you can able to got it, right? So zero degree latitude is already explained in detail. They are the latitude which are given special names. The 23 1/2 degree north latitude is called the Tropic of Cancer, and 66 1/2 degree north latitude is called the Arctic Circle. Then 23 1/2 degree south latitude is known as the Tropic of Capricorn, and the 66 degree south latitude is called the Antarctic Circle. Do you all got it? Yes. Here is important lines in the latitude. Equator, what now I have explained, that is Arctic Ocean, Tropic of Cancer, Equator, Tropic of Capricorn, and the Arctic Circle is explained clearly here. The equator is 0°, Tropic of Cancer 23.5° north, and Tropic of Capricorn is 23.5° south. Arctic Circle 66.5° north, Antarctica Circle 66.5° south, and North Pole 90° north, and South Pole is 90° south. Clear? Yes, we shall move for longitude. Longitude is a measurement of the east or west or the prime meridian. Longitude is measured by imaginary lines that run around the earth vertically up and down and meet at the north and south poles. Each meridian measures 1 degree of longitude. The distance around the earth measures 360°. The longitude line of the degree is known as the prime meridian. Clear? And it's divide the world into the eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere. Now we are going to see that the longitude along with the horizontal lines or the latitude. There are also some vertical lines on the globe. You can able to see the vertical lines, right? Horizontal lines, you know how it is, and vertical line. So the The imaginary vertical lines drawn between the poles on the globe are known as longitude. Like latitude, these are not parallel lines, but they are of the same length. These lines meet at the poles, which are called meridians. Okay, these lines meet at the poles, that is called meridian. That is called, we are saying, the prime meridian. So they all also measured in degree. The prime meridian is a meridian which passes through the Greenwich in England. This is also called as a 0° meridian. So they have in the right side, you can able to see the 0°, right? Yes. The prime meridian divides the world into eastern and western hemisphere. Then one either side of the prime meridian, there are the 180 meridians, is that right? So they are the longitude in total, with the 180 longitude in each hemisphere. The eastern meridian, so the many as E, and we can mention as E, and western meridian we can mark as W. The most important thing is to be noted that the 180° east and west meridians are one and the same. Clear?
Yes.
Important lines in the longitude, the prime meridian, yes, that is an important line in the longitude, the Greenwich meridian, which travels through the England, right? Yes, the international date line is a longitude 180°. Again, there are the four most significant imaginary lines running across surface of the earth or the equator: Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn, and the prime meridian. Here we can able to see the latitude and longitude difference. So it ran from the east to west, it ran from the south to north. They are the 181 lines of the latitude. When you count, you can able to see 181 lines in the latitude, and in this side 360 lines in the longitude. So longest latitude secret divided the earth into northern hemisphere and south hemisphere. When coming to the longitude, it is separated into eastern and western. In latitude, northern and southern. Clear? So they are parallel and never meet each other. There is a parallel, they can't able to meet each other, but it is not a parallel longitude, is not a parallel that can meet at poles. This all between the longitude, latitude and longitude. Now we are going to see about the weather. So weather is a day-to-day state of the atmosphere, and its short-term variation in minutes to weeks. People generally think of weather as the combination of the temperature, humidity, precipitation, cloudiness, and visibility and wind. The state of art and the atmosphere at the particular time and place, the change in the condition of the air, water around an area, change causes changes in weather. Types of weather: sunny, coldy, rainy, windy, and snowy. So now we have seen about the weather, right? So when we talk about the cold day, hot day, cloudy day, they are talking about the weather of a country, right? The weather refers to how hot, how cold, and rainy. You can able to see in the slide, right? First slide. Can able to see the weather refers to how hot, cold, rainy, windy, cloudy, and is over short period of the time. When one talks of humidity, warm, cold, example, it is very cold at Ooty. So it refers at the climate. Clear? So anything that refers to the weather condition of a country over a long period of a time is called climate of a country. So this is about the weather. So as the people live in this world, the food and other vary, the climate also vary from place to place. The climate varies mainly due to the following factors. Clear? So as the distance of the place from the equator varies, the climate also varies. So this makes the North India cooler than the South India. The highest above the sea level is another factor. The higher above the sea level is the place, cooler it's become. For example, we can say Himalayas. Oh, clear? So distance from the sea or the mountains also affect the climate of a country. The coastal plains are not very hot but are humid because of the sea breeze, while the northern plains are cold due to cool winds from the Himalayas. Clear?
Yes.
It's all about the weather. So in this type, we are going to see about the sunny, coldy, and windy. The sunny means shining with a bright sunlight. There are no clouds in the sky. We can't able to see anything, right? So we can say this is summer season also. Beginning in the March to end up in the June, the South India is become the hot in the March and start to rain in the June. While in the North India, summer start in the April, end up in the June. So hailstorms are common and occur when the dry and moist air passes come in the contact with each other, right? So during this season, sunrise fall directly on the equator. In summer, it is very hot in the almost all parts of except in the North India. So in this season, days are longer at the nights. Hot dry winds blow in the northern plains called Loo. They are also called dust storms. So most of the time the climate is dry, there is a scanty rainfall. During this season, people wear the cotton clothes. Clear? So when we come into the cold dean means the entire sky is covered by the clouds, right? So this season, it starts from the June onwards. Not from the June, it starts for rainy season, okay? So how we can describe that is a cloudy season? A day that is a gray and coldy is overcast and a very dull, unless sky. So these are described in this way. That is called cloudy. Clear? So when we coming to the rainy season, all amounts of rain that fall at the particular time of year, that is called rainy season. So this season only starts from the June onwards, right? So winds with the moisture from the Arabian Sea over the Bay of Bengal begins blowing to the land. So such winds are called the monsoon winds, bringing a rain. So in the South India, this season starts from the June, while in the North India start from the end of the June or beginning of the July. So it continues till September. So some parts, especially western coast and the northeast states, get heavy rains in that time. Clear? So part of the northern plains and Deccan Plateau also receives heavy rainfall. The Great Indian Desert and the Rain of Kutch receives scanty rainfall. Clear? So people very casually and use an umbrella to protect from this rainy season. Yes, when we come into the windy season, so this marked by the strong wind or by the more wind than usually a windy season. So this season start in October and continuously till the February or March. So this seasons are very short days and long nights. In Himalayas, there is a very heavy snowfall. The northern plains are very cold during this season. They are formed days and cloud nights in the desert. And coming to the January, in the coldest month in the season. So occasional rains bring down the temperature in southern India when winters are very moderate. So they are the brief spring followed by the summer. The people wear the woolen clothes in that season. Clear? When we coming to the snowy place is covered in the snow. A snowy day is a day that when a lot of snow has fallen. So when we think about the snow, we think about the Christmas, right? We all enjoyed celebrating the Christmas in the snowy day. Yes, climate. So climate is a description of a long-term pattern of the weather in a particular area. Sometimes scientists define the climate as the average weather for the particular region on the time period, usually taken over 30 years. It's really an average pattern of the weather for a particular region. The climate is a long-term pattern of the weather in a particular area. Weather can change from hour to hour, day to day, month to month, or year to year. So that's all about the climate. Then in the hilly region, the summer or the melt and the winter or the cold. So climate is a statistical weather information that provide the information about the average weather condition of the particular place over a long period. So you can got it an idea difference of weather and the climate. So atmosphere condition keeping on changing from time to time. The change of atmosphere condition are called weather. Clear? So the corresponds to a very limited period. On the contrary, climate is the average weather condition of a larger area on the earth's surface for the longer period of the time. So climate is not same everywhere. It is vary from time to time, from the place to place. In a country, some places are cold, some places are very hot throughout the year. The various climate condition are caused by various factors. The most important factor of the climate is temperature. They all got it? Yes. So the most of our India is in subtropical country, and that means very hot summer, humidity, rain season, and mild winters. Here is a type of climate: tropical climate, desert climate, temperate climate, polar climate, and Mediterranean climate. So we're going to see each climate in brief explanation. Here is a tropical climate. So tropical climate is a type of a climate typical in the tropics. It is a damp climate in which all 12 months have been temperatures above 18 degrees Celsius, that is in bracket 64.4 degrees Celsius. Some of the tropical areas have rainfall throughout the year, usually in the afternoon. Others have a wet season and the dry season. Then in the tropical climate have also is a place to enjoy the tropical climate to the Amazon rainforest in Brazil and West Africa, Congo Basin, and the rainforest and Malaysia and Indonesia. So overall, what is a tropical climate is? The tropical climate is one of the five major climate group in the Köppen climate. So Köppen climate classification. So the tropical climate or characteristics by the monthly average temperature of the 18 degrees Celsius or higher year around and feature hot temperature. So the annual temperature ranges in tropical climate is very normally very small. So what is the desert climate? The desert climate or the arid climate is a climate which there is an excess of evaporation or the precipitation. The typically blade rocky or the sandy surface in the desert climate hold little moisture and they evaporate the little rainfall they receive. Here in the desert climate we can receive the very low rainfall and we can't able to see the rain there. Clear? So the places who enjoy the temperature climates are the Kalahari Desert in southern Africa, next in Sahara Desert in the North Africa, Arabian Desert in the Middle East, the Thar Desert in the South Asia. Clear? Next, we shall move for temperature climate. So when we come into the temperature climate, or the generally defined as the environment with moderate rainfall spread across the year and portion of the year with spectrotic dry rot, sporadic drought, and a mild to warm summers and cool to cold the winters. So here is the temperature climate who enjoys here. The northwestern Europe and the south northwestern North America, southeastern Australia, and most of the New So the temperature climate are generally defined as the environmental with moderate rainfall spread across a year or the portion of the year. So about the temperature climate. Next, polar climate. So polar climate is a place where the climate usually has a temperature below the freezing, is icy and covered in the snow. So these areas do not get the direct heat or the sunlight from the sun. So polar climate are located at the North Pole of the Arctic and the South Pole of the continent of the Arctic. So here we can see who all enjoys the polar climate: Canada, Greenland, Iceland, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Russia, and Newfoundland. So overall, what is the meaning for polar climate? The polar climate regions are the characteristics by the lack of warm summer. Every month in a polar climate has average temperature of the less than 10 degrees Celsius region with a polar climate. Cover more than 20% of the Earth's surface. This all about the polar climate. You can able to see in this picture polar climate. Russia, Finland, Sweden, Norway, Iceland, they can able to enjoy these places with the polar climate. Next, we are moving to Mediterranean climate. So Mediterranean climate are characteristic by the hot dry summer and cool and wet winters and located between about the 30 degree and 45 degree latitude north and south of the equator and north of the western sides of the continent. So who all can enjoy this Mediterranean climate is Spain, Portugal, southern France, Italy, Greece, and Turkey. So my dear children, in Mediterranean who all can enjoy, we can see that, right? So what is the concept of the Mediterranean climate? It's major climate type of the Köppen classification, characteristic by the hot dry summer and cool wet winter and located between about 30 degree and 45 degree latitude north and south of the equator and on the western sides of the continent. So this is meaning for our Mediterranean climate. So here we can able to see the places of the Mediterranean climate, who can enjoy the Mediterranean climate. So here is the difference between the weather and the climate. So day to day information of the class 10 periodic change of the particular area at a specific time is called weather. The climate of the statistical information of the average weather condition of a specific region for more than 30 years. So here we can see that day-to-day information, here statistical information, clear? So here the particular area address a specific time is called weather. The average weather condition of the specific region of more than 30 years. Clear? When coming to the second point, change in the weather condition can be observed very frequently. But in the climate, change in the climate take longer time to change. In weather, weather forecasting is observed by the meteorological department, but in the climatology, the scientific study of the climate which eaters describe as average weather condition over the time. Coming to the last point, weather is affected by the temperature, pressure, humidity, cloudiness. Atmosphere condition is at the location like humidity, temperature, sunshine, etc. are affected by this climate. So zones of the earth. Here is the zones of the earth. So our earth is divided into five distinct zones based on the climate condition, right? So what are the tropical, temperature, frigid. Here the world is sometimes divided into five zones according to the latitude. Tropical or the diroid zone lies near the what this slide is always before itself we have seen in the introduction, whether you all got it my dear children, right? Yes, I have explained you this tropical or the diroid zone is it's the same and lies near the equator, extend to the Tropic of Cancer in the north and Tropic of Capricorn in the south, and north and south Bicrid zones also known as Arctic and Antarctica lies near the poles. Already we have seen this, whether you all remember, right? Here is a type of zones. The world is sometimes divided into five zones, right, according to the latitude. So what are the five types of zone? North Bicrid zone, North temperature zone, torrid zone. Torrid zone is equal to the tropical zone. Okay, we can say tropical or torrid zone. And this next, the South Bicrid zone, South temperature zone, tropical zone. So tropical zone is a region between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn on the Earth's surface. This region shows hot climate. This area includes all the areas of the Earth, whereas the sun reaches a point directly overhead at least at the 1 year. So you can able to got it. So in the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn on the Earth's surface is a region show hot climate. In that they show the a hot climate, but the sun reaches a point directly to the least at the 1 year. Next, the tropical zone is also called a diroid zone. So between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, it falls vertically in that region. So children, temperature is very high in that region, in temperature region. So this regions, they are deserts. The rainfall is very high in that region, very high in that region. So the South India forms a part of this zone. So here we can able to see the summer solstice. The summer solstice is the longest day of the summer season. So it occurs when the sun is directly over the Tropic of Cancer, or the more specifically right over the 23.5 degree north latitude. In summer solstice, we can see in the northern hemisphere, the solstice occurs between the June 20 and June 22 in the northern hemisphere. And summer solstice occurs on the December 21 or 22. So we all know that. So in this slide, they have described clearly June solstice and December solstice. So everything to know about the longest day of the year, summer solstice 2021 on June 21. Here, winter solstice. At the winter solstice, the sun travels the shortest path throughout the sky on the day, therefore, as the least daylight, and the longest night, right? So when the winter solstice happens in the northern hemisphere, the North Pole is tilted above the 23.4 degrees 27 minutes away from the sun. So winter solstice, they have says that the sun travels from the shortest path through all the sky that day, therefore the least daylight, longest night. So this is all about the winter solstice. So the winter solstice occurs annually at December 21 or 22, or for the southern hemisphere the winter solstice occurs June 20 or 21. So here is the difference between the summer solstice and winter solstice. When we see the summer solstice, experience the longest day and shortest night of the year. Now coming to the winter solstice, is experience shortest day and longest night of the year. And every year on June 21st summer solstice happens. But when coming to the winter, every year in the month of December, that is in the June 21st, when coming to the winter, it is in the on the December. They may vary. They may can be vary. Okay. So it happens when the Earth tilts on the axis of the maximum towards the sun. It happens in the north. Poles of the Earth tilt from the sun. Away from the sun. This is a maximum that will be far away from the sun. The fourth point is the sun appears at the highest elevation during the noontime and the sun and stands still directly over the Tropic of Cancer located at the 23.5 degree latitude north, right? So next, this last point of the winter solstice is the sun stands still directly over the Tropic of Capricorn in the southern hemisphere and reaches its southerly declination located at the 23.5 degree Tropic of Zone. The tropical or dyroid zone lies near the equator and extend to the Tropic of Cancer in the north and the south. So the north and the south bigger zones also known as Arctic and the Antarctic in the other poles. So you can able to see in the picture, right? Already we have explained you about the tropical and tropical or the dyroid zone. Coming to temperature zone, the part of the Earth's surface between the Arctic Circle and the Tropic of Cancer, or between the Antarctica Circle, the Tropic of Capricorn are characteristic by the temperature climate. Clear? Yes. Next, the regions between the Tropic of Cancer and the Arctic Circle and between the Tropic of Capricorn and the Arctic Circle are called as the temperature zones. The sun rays falls scientifically on this region. So the temperature is low and pleasant here. The people are off and healthy with the good complication. So what is meant by temperature zone is the temperature climate will be generally defined as an environment with moderate rainfall. Okay, so moderate rainfall spread across the year or the portion of the year. So with spiral drought and melt to form the summer and cool to the winter. So what is a north temperature zone is? A north temperature zone extends from the Tropic of Cancer is approximately 23.5 degree north latitude to the Arctic Circle and approximately 66.5 degree of north latitude. So north temperature zone lies between the Arctic Circle and the Tropic of Cancer. So you can able to see in the slide the north temperature zone and the south temperature zone. First is the Arctic Circle, next is Tropic of Cancer, equator, Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. Next, south temperature zone. So south temperature zone extends from the Tropic of Capricorn is approximately 23.5 degree south latitude to the Antarctic Circle, the approximately 66.5 degree south latitude. So you can able to see in the picture, first stop is North Pole, the sound last is South Pole. The first is formed by Arctic Circle, next is Tropic of Cancer, equator, Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctica Circle. Next, south temperature zone lies between the Antarctic Circle and the Tropic of Capricorn. So here is a clear picture. You can able to see the difference of the north temperature zone and south temperature zone, what I have explained now, right? So Arctic Circle, Tropic of Cancer, equator, Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. Next, polar zone.
The polar zone encompasses the area around the North and South Poles, starting from the North Pole. This zone stretches the Arctic Circle in the North Hemisphere and reaches even the further south in North America and Asia. Next, the polar zone is also called the Vigrid zone. The regions between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole and between the Arctic Circle and South Pole is called the polar region. So what is the meaning for polar region is, the polar climate regions are characteristic by the lack of warmth in summer. So every month in the polar climate has an average temperature of less than 10 degrees Celsius. So regions with polar climate is cover more than 20% of the earth area. So this is a concept of the polar zone. This zone is extremely cold. We all know that this zone is extremely cold, my dear children. So the water freezes the most of the area where was covered with the ice and snow. So kitchen is called as a tundra region. The population is very little and some people there is no population at all. So North Vigrid Zone, the region to the north to the Arctic Circle centered on the North Pole. The North Vigrid Zone between the North Pole at 90 degree north and the Arctic Circle at 66 degree 33 minutes 48.5 north covers a 4.12% of the Earth's surface. Here you can able to see the Vigrid Zone, right? South Vigrid Zone, the region around the South Pole, Antarctica and surrounding water. The South Vigrid Zone from the Antarctica Circle at the 66 degree 33 minutes 48.7 south, the South Pole at the 90 degree south covers a 4.12% of the Earth's surface. Whether you have got it, this is the difference between South Vigrid Zone and North Vigrid Zone. Here is a difference. Zones about Vigrid Zone, temperature zone and tidal zone. We're going to see it separately. In the Vigrid Zone, North Vigrid Zone is between the Arctic Circle 66.5 north and then the North Pole 90 north, right? In South Vigrid Zone, between the Antarctic Circle 66.5 north and South Pole is 90 south. In temperature zone, North Temperature Zone, which is between the Tropic of Cancer 23.5 north and the Arctic Circle 66.5 north, and second point is in that temperature zone, the South Temperature Zone, which is between the Tropic of Capricorn 23.5 south and the Antarctic Circle is 66.5 south. So when we seeing this difference between the Vigrid Zone, temperature, tidal zone, you can able to remember this are very important zones and locations. Then torrid zone, located between the Tropic of Cancer and 23.5 north and the Tropic of Capricorn 23.5 south. Tidal zone and Vigrid Zone. Here we can able to see the difference between the torrid zone and the Vigrid Zone. So torrid zone we can also call as a tropical zone, right? Yes. So it lies between the Tropic of Cancer in the north and Tropic of Capricorn in the south. In Vigrid Zone, it lies between the Arctic Circle and the North Pole in the northern hemisphere and Antarctica Circle and South Pole in the south hemisphere. Okay, it's nothing but, my dear children, North Pole in the northern hemisphere and in South Pole it's the southern hemisphere, right? Next, the sun rays fall directly and provide the maximum heat to the zone. And Vigrid Zone, you can see the sun rays are slanting and provide less heat to the zone. In tidal zone, experience scorching heat in daytime and heavy rain by evening. In Vigrid Zone, remain to show cover throughout the year. So here is a temperature zone. Areas between the Tropic of Cancer, Capricorn, the Arctic or Antarctic Circle called the North and South Temperature Zone. Second is as moderate temperature. The midday sun never shines overhead across any latitude. So this is about the temperature zone. So here is a basic compound tropical zone, temperature polar zone differences in climate. So we can see the first climate. A general pattern of the tropic climate is warm temperature. In temperature zone, climates are generally defined as a environmental with a moderate rainfall spread across that temperature area. In polar zone, the polar climate regions are characteristic by the lack of warm summers. Next, temperature. The temperatures of every month are above degree Celsius. In temperature zone, the monthly temperature is above 10 degrees Celsius in the warmest months and above 3 degrees Celsius in the coldest months. In polar zone, the annual range in the temperature is both polar regions approximately 30 degrees Celsius and their winter temperatures are below the 30 degrees Celsius. This is all about the topic. Tropical we have seen now. Now it is, this is the temperature. Next is a cloud. The cotton is one of the best fabric for summer on the hot weather, right? So in temperature zone, winter jacket, light to medium coat, short sleeveless shirts, comfort available, able to shoes. And polar travelers wear the red poam trouser and sick pant. Net food. So in tropical zones, sugar cane, soya beans, rice and beets, potatoes will be present in the tropical zone. When coming to the temperature, apple, pear, peach, grape and strawberries will be present. And polar zone, freeze, dried and cheese nutrition will be present in the food pot. Here we come to the conclusions all about the zones of the earth. So human induced climate and changes contributed to changing the patterns to extreme weather across the globe. So from the longer and the hotter heat waves to heater rains, extreme the weather is on the rise, and the indications are that it will continue to increase in both predictable and unpredictable ways. So these were all the zones of the earth. Children, do you enjoy this class? Do you have any doubts in that? Hope you were understood about it. Okay, children. Bye. Take care. See you in the next class. Thank you.